मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू बैक टू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ माई वीडियो. सो इन दिस वीडियो, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट रिवर्सिबल एंड इरिवर्सिबल चेंज. नाउ द थर्ड पॉइंट इज डिजरेबल एंड अनडिजरेबल चेंजेस. चेंजेस विच आर फॉर आवर बेनिफिट, द चेंजेस दैट टेक प्लेस फॉर आवर बेनिफिट आर कॉल्ड डिजरेबल चेंजेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कुकिंग ऑफ फूड, राइपनिंग ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड change of season, these are desirable change that is required or that is benefit for our life. In some cases, irreversible changes results in the formation of new material. In some cases, irreversible change take place, but these irreversible change into a new material which may be desirable, that might be desirable for us. Just like milk turning into curd and formation of compost from cow dung and vegetable waste are formation of new material. But as the new material is formed, this kind of irreversible change is desirable for us because they are helpful for us. Breaking of glass, rotting of food, flooding of river are irreversible change but undesirable change. These are undesirable change. Now, those changes which are harmful for our consumption, or those changes that are harmful for us are known as undesirable changes. Those substances that are beneficial for us are called desirable changes, and those changes which are harmful to us are called undesirable changes. Example, flood, drought, accident, these are example of undesirable changes. Next, a change is desirable sometime and undesirable at the other time. Sometime a change is very nice for us and other time the change is not good for us. For example, burning of fuel to get heat and light is desirable change, and burning of a factory or a house is undesirable changes. Sometimes the changes are benefit for us, sometimes the changes are undesirable for us. Sometimes with the desirable change and undesirable changes also occur. Sometimes with desirable change, so means the changes that are useful for us, with that change some harmful undesirable changes also take place. For example, cutting of trees is desirable for those who use wood for making furniture. Now, cutting of wood is desirable changes for those who uses wood for making furniture, and on the other side it is undesirable for us because the amount of oxygen carbon dioxide balance in the atmosphere gets disturbed. Fourth point is periodic and non-periodic changes. Now, changes which occur after regular interval of time is called periodic changes. Changes that occur after regular interval of time are called periodic changes. The phase of the moon, heartbeat and tides in seas are periodic changes. So what are periodic changes? Changes which occur after regular interval of time are called periodic changes. Example, phases of the moon, changing of the phases of moon. Second, heartbeat, and third one, tides in the sea water. These are example of periodic changes. We can predict the time when these changes will be repeated. We can tell the time when these changes will be repeated again. But some changes do not occur at regular interval of time. Such changes are called non-periodic changes. Some changes are called non-periodic changes. So what I told non-periodic changes? Changes that does not occur at regular interval of time are called non-periodic changes. Example, an earthquake, cyclone, rusting of iron are non-periodic changes. These are the example of non-periodic changes. Now next, fifth point, physical and chemical changes. So what are physical changes? Changes in which no new substance or material is formed is called physical changes. So what are physical changes? Changes in which no new substance are formed are called physical changes. In physical changes, the shape, size and state of a substance may change. In physical change, what can be changes? Which thing can change? The shape, size and state of a substance can change. Evaporation and condensation of water, stretching and relaxation of rubber band, making paper boats, the glowing of bulbs, inflammation of balloon are some example of physical changes. Physical changes are usually reversible. Now, this physical change that is taking place are reversible, means they can be reversed, they can come back to its original position. So, what are the example I told physical changes? Evaporation and condensation of water, stretching and relaxation of rubber band, making of paper boat, the glowing of bulb, inflammation of balloon, these all are example of physical change. Physical change can be irreversible. Chemical change. After physical change comes the chemical change. What is chemical change? A changes in which a new and different substance is formed is called chemical change. A change in which new and different substance is formed is called chemical change. In such changes, new substances are formed that possess different properties, and the substance that is formed, the new substance, it has different properties like curdling of milk, cooking of food, ripening of fruits, rusting of iron are some other example of chemical changes. When an iron object is left exposed to the moisture, you will see a reddish brown color can be seen on top of the iron. This is what? This is the rust. We call it as rust. That is the formation of iron oxide on top of the iron. During lightning of candle, melting of wax is a physical change, while burning of wax is a chemical change. When we light a candle, melting of wax, when the wax starts melting, it is the physical change. While the burning of a wax is a chemical change. Both physical and chemical change can occur at the same time. Both physical and chemical change can occur at the same time. Now, number 6, endothermic and exothermic change. When we keep ice cube in a bowl on a table, they melt without hinting. When an ice cube is kept in a bowl on a table without heating, it changes into water. How does it happen? Ice absorb heat. How does it happen? It happen because ice, what it does? The surrounding is hot. So ice being cold, it absorb the heat and it starts melting. The change which take place by the absorption of heat is called endothermic change. Now the change that take place with the absorption of heat, when it takes the heat within itself, it is called endothermic changes. Example, evaporation of water occurs. When does it occur? When it absorbs heat from the sunlight. This is an example of endothermic change. Next, when a fuel is burnt, it gives out heat. When any fuel, it might be coal, it might be wood, it might be petroleum or anything, when it is burnt, heat is given out. Heat is given out. And the changes in which heat is given out is called exothermic change. The changes in which heat is liberated out or given out is called exothermic change. Example, a cup of hot tea that becomes cold by giving out heat to the atmosphere is an example of exothermic change. Now, if you take a boiling water and keep it in a room, suddenly after some time what we will see, the boiling water which was hot, it becomes cold because it gives away the heat. It does not absorb. It gives away the heat to the surrounding. That is why it is exothermic reaction. Next, changes caused by pressure or force. Changes that is caused by pressure or force. Now, early in the morning when we want to brush our teeth, what we do? We take toothbrush and toothpaste. Now, if we don't press, if we don't put force in the toothpaste, will the toothpaste come out? No, it will not come out. When we put extra pressure or force in the pouch of our toothpaste, what we will see? The toothpaste comes out when we put extra pressure in it. So, this change is caused by pressure or force that we have put in on the toothpaste pouch. Number 8. Changes caused by expansion and contraction of material. Changes that is being caused by contraction and expansion of material. Solid, liquid and gas. All changes on heating. When we heat solid, it changes. If we heat liquid, it changes. If we heat gas, all. So, the solid, liquid and gases, all changes on heating. Heating can expand them, but the amount of expansion differ in solid, liquid and gas. Heating can, if we heat them, we can expand them, but the amount of expansion differs from solid to liquid, liquid to gas. Now, liquid to gas expands then most, while solid expands the least. Now, gas, it expands the more, whereas solid, it expands very less. So, cooling causes material to contact. When we cool, suppose we take a water and put it in the deep refrigerator, it cools, the water changes into ice. So, that means the water has contracted. It has contracted. Solid contract the least, while gases contract the most. Now, solid, what I told, converting liquid to water, liquid to ice, it contract. And again, from liquid, when I will heat, it changes into gas. So, expansion and contraction in solid. What happens when there is expansion and contraction in solid? Most of the solid expand on heating, but on cooling, they come back to their original shape. Now, most of the substance, metal that we see, when we heat them, they expand. But when we leave them for cooling, once they cool down, they come back to their original shape and size. Now, the property of contraction and expansion in solid is also used to fit a rim around the cartwheel. Now, suppose here one cartwheel is given here. One cartwheel is given in the picture. So, when a cartwheel wants, when this wheel has to be fitted with a metal rim, the metal rim is heated. When the metal rim is heated, it expands, and once it gets expanded, we can easily put it into the cart rim, and when it cools down, it will come back to its original place and it will have a firm grip into the what? Into the rim, iron into the cart wheel. Now, expansion on contraction in liquid. Expansion and contraction on liquid. You must have seen a clinical thermometer. You have seen the clinical thermometer that is used to measure the body temperature. For measuring body temperature, the bulb of the thermometer contains mercury. See in the figure, one mercury thermometer, clinical thermometer is there. Mercury is present in it. It is used for measuring body temperature. The bulb of thermometer contain a mercury. This mercury expand when little heat is also given to that part. When little heat is also absorbed by the mercury, there is an expansion and we can note down the temperature of our body. As a result, the level of mercury rises in the glass tube, thereby indicating the temperature. And by this way, we can indicate the temperature of the body of a person. If the bulb of a thermometer is dispersed in the cold water, now if you take that thermometer and put it in the cold water, what we will see? The liquid contacts, means the mercury that is present, it will come in contact, and the label of the mercury in the glass tube falls from the above, and the label that we have seen, our body temperature, it comes back to the original position. We conclude that liquid expands on heating and concludes and contracts on cooling. So from this we can conclude that when we heat liquid, it expands. When we cool liquid, it contracts. Expansion and contraction in gases. Expansion and contraction in gases. Inflated balloon inside a room burst more frequently in summer than in winter. Now, inflated balloon means the balloon that has what? That is air in it. Now, if you put an inflated balloon inside your room during the summer time, we see the balloon starts bursting. But when we keep this balloon inside our room in the winter time, the balloon doesn't burst. This is because the heat causes the air inside the balloon to expand at the room temperature. This is because the heat that is present in the balloon, inside the balloon, it expands according to the room temperature and the balloon bursts. This shows that gas expands on heating. If an inflated balloon is tied at the mouth of a bottle, see, you can figure is given at the mouth of the bottle, and the bottle is placed in cold water, then the balloon shrink in size. Now, if the balloon is placed in cold water, you see the balloon shrink in size, means the balloon that was bulging, it gets smaller in size. But when we put it in hot water, what we see? We see the balloon getting inflated. Why? This is because the air inside the balloon contracts on cooling. Why the balloon gets inflated? Why the balloon gets small shrink? This is because the air that is present inside the balloon contracts. And when we put the balloon in hot water, what happens? The air inside becomes hot, and as it becomes hot, it rises up and bulges the balloon.